in the fascinating depths of the ocean, beneath the roar of the waves and the rhythm of marine life, there is a creature that stands out for its uniqueness and versatility. The octopus. In my 3D animation below, we will take an unparalleled look into the anatomy of this masterful sea creature. The body of the octopus mainly consists of two parts, the mantle and the 8 tentacles. The mantle is a heavily muscled, sac-like structure that contains all the major organs, such as the kidneys, mid-gut gland, gills, stomach, intestines, brain, and reproductive organs. These strong muscles not only protect the organs, but also support the animal's breathing and contraction. The octopus's 8 arms and tentacles are unique in that they have no rigid skeletal elements. Instead, they consist of a three-dimensional network of muscle fibers and rely on a system called the muscular hydrostat through a special arrangement of 3 main muscle orientations: transverse, longitudinal, and helical muscle fibers. They achieve an impressive variety of movements and deformations. The predominant muscle typology is obliquely striated, and this special arrangement enables fast movements, especially in the tentacles. There are 2 rows of small round suction cups on each arm. These are specially designed to hold objects. They generate low pressure and conform to the surface to form an impermeable seal. These suction cups can be rotated in all directions and consist of 2 main parts: the outer cavity, called the infundibulum, and the central cavity, or acetabulum. A common octopus has about 2,000 suction cups. The ability of the octopus to regenerate its arms and tentacles is a well-known phenomenon that has been known since Aristotle's time. In a process called regeneration, specialized cells begin to grow and develop into a new arm, a process that can take several weeks or even months. The funnel organ, also known as the siphon or funnel, is located at the bottom of the transition between the mantle and the head. It is an integral part of the respiratory system, expelling water that has previously passed through the gills from the mantle cavity, taking in oxygen and releasing carbon dioxide. In addition, the siphon serves as a propulsion system. In the so-called jet propulsion, water is forced through the siphon. The tentacles of the octopus become rigid, and the octopus forms a torpedo-like shape to shoot through the water at great speed. In addition to jet propulsion, octopuses can move in a variety of other ways. One method is crawling, where they use their arms to pull themselves along the seabed. They can also swim by moving their bodies rhythmically. Each of these methods of locomotion offers the octopus different advantages depending on the environment and situation. As a soft, muscular, and nutritious animal, the octopus is exposed to many dangers in the ocean. Numerous predators, including sharks, bony fish, marine mammals, seabirds, and other cephalopods, hunt them for their easily digestible, protein-rich bodies. Unlike other mollusks, such as snails and clams, cephalopods are virtually defenseless as they have lost their outer shell. However, their ability to camouflage, made possible by highly developed skin tissue, offers a life-saving advantage. The skin of the octopus consists of chromatophores, iridophores, leukophores, and papillae. These organs and cells are controlled by the brain and allow octopuses to change color and adapt to their environment in a fraction of a second. Chromatophores, pigment-filled skin organs, can produce a variety of colors, including black, brown, orange, red, and yellow. They're located under the skin and change shape through muscle contraction, making the pigment visible. Iridophores are another type of skin cell that produce green, blue, silver, and gold colors through stacks of reflective plates, depending on the viewing angle. In contrast to chromatophores, they react more slowly and may not be directly controlled by neuronal input. Leukophores scatter light across the spectrum and therefore appear white. They contribute to color matching by reflecting wavelengths of light that are filtered by seawater at shallower depths. Papillae are raised structures on the octopus's skin that can change their size to change the texture of the skin and allow the octopus to camouflage better. By altering the papillae, the octopus can mimic a variety of surface textures. These structures and cells work together to give the octopus amazing camouflage capabilities. The ability to adapt color and texture is critical to the octopus's survival and hunting strategies, allowing it to adapt to different environments and effectively hide from enemies. The octopus ink sac, a remarkable organ located near the digestive tract, produces ink as a defense mechanism. When a threat is perceived, the octopus can release a dark cloud of ink that confuses predators and provides an escape route. Equipped with special muscles, the octopus can increase the pressure in the ink sac and thus release the ink in a targeted manner. The octopus has a closed circulatory system. This is characterized by three hearts and blue blood. Two of the hearts are located near the gills and pump blood through them. The third, centrally located heart, distributes oxygen-rich blood throughout the body. This special system ensures an effective supply of oxygen and nutrients to all organs and muscles. The bluish blood is the result of the oxygen carrier protein hemocyanin, which is less efficient than our hemoglobin. However, the three hearts enable an effective distribution of blood despite the lower oxygen binding efficiency. The brain of the octopus, localized between the eyes and structured in a ring like a donut around the esophagus, is remarkably different from that of many other creatures. With around 500 million neurons, similar to dogs, the nervous system of this mollusk is fascinating. Around 180 million neurons are concentrated in the central brain, with the remaining 320 million distributed across the ganglia of its eight arms. Each arm is partially autonomous due to clusters of neurons, with these neurons connected by suction cups, enabling the octopus to recognize touch, smell, and taste. Each arm can act independently and transmit important information to the central brain. Despite the lack of a fixed body image, octopuses compensate by having mini-brains in their arms that enable decentralized information processing, freeing up the central brain for more complex tasks. Octopuses show remarkable cognitive abilities. They have short and long-term memory, show curiosity in exploring objects, exhibit play behavior, and can even recognize and distinguish individual humans. Octopuses have a special gland for producing and storing venom, which they use to paralyze their prey. Without this venom, it would be challenging to immobilize their prey. Although all octopuses are venomous, only the blue-ringed species pose a serious threat to humans. Their venom contains the potent neurotoxin tetrodotoxin, making them one of the most venomous sea creatures. The digestion of the octopus begins with its sharp beak. This is located at the lower end of the head and is surrounded by a soft horn substance. The beak is designed to crush and cut food. Below the beak is another organ called the radula, a kind of tongue that is covered with many small teeth and barbs. This organ is used to scrape and tear food. Once the food has been ingested, it enters the octopus's crop, where it is temporarily stored. From there, the food passes into the stomach, where it is broken down further with the help of acidic digestive enzymes. However, the actual peak of digestion takes place in the so-called hepatocancreas, or digestive gland, also known as the octopus liver. This gland is capable of producing a variety of enzymes that break down the nutrients in the ingested food into their components, which are then transported via the octopus's blood system to the various tissues and organs, where they are used to produce energy or to build new cells. The gonad, or genital gland, produces sperm or eggs depending on the sex of the animal. Males have specialized arms, called hectocotyles, which are used to insert their spermatophores into the females. The females, on the other hand, carry the eggs in their mantle cavities and guard them until the larvae hatch. After the sexual act, the females of some species eat the males. After laying hundreds of thousands of eggs in a cave, They guard them for 1 to 2 months and do not eat during this time. As soon as the young octopuses hatch, the females also die. With an anatomy as complex and dynamic as a living work of art underwater, the octopus reminds us of the breathtaking diversity of life in our oceans. It's great that you are here to discover the fascinating anatomy of the octopus. If you want to experience more of these exciting insights into the animal world, I'd love to have you subscribe. A like from you means a lot to me and motivates me to continue sharing informative content. Do you have any questions or suggestions for future topics? Feel free to write them in the comments. And don't forget to activate the bell so you never miss a new video. See you next time.